Welcome to my channel Question Bank. In this video, I am going to discuss some more questions regarding engineering mathematics. And the chapter in this video is vector calculus. It's vector calculus. And the question level will be discussed is very easy. That means the question levels are 1 mark questions which can be asked exams like OPSC, Assistant Executive Engineer, BARC or JEE, SSC JEE or RRB JEE. These like exams can ask the questions like this. These are easy questions, and honestly I am going to discuss these questions, and these questions are collected from previous year GATE questions or some are developed by me. So let's have the first question. First question is, the expression curl of grad of f, where f is a scalar function, is, that is, curl of gradient of f is what? This is option number D, that is a vector of zero magnitude. How it can be explained? First thing, as this is a curl, the result will be a vector, first thing. And next, so what is the vector? This is not a vector, this is also not a vector, this is also not a vector. So this is the correct answer. In this way we can select the option, but according to theory I want to explain here what is curl, gradient and divergence. Only to revise here, what is curl, divergent and gradient I want to discuss. Generally gradient, in case of gradient, the del operator, that is the differential operator for the vector fields, takes a scalar, that is f here is scalar, and produces a vector, because this one, the differential operator is itself a vector, that is del by del x I cap, it may be I vector, this is the unit vectors along x axis, plus del by del y j cap, plus del by del z k cap. As this is a vector, when it operates a scalar quantity, it turns it into a vector. So we have to simply memorize that in case of gradient, scalar turns into a vector, first thing. Next, divergence. In case of divergence, it takes a vector quantity. That means the dot product of differential operator, that is del operator, and a vector field is the divergence, and it produces, as it is dot product, it will produce a scalar. We can represent it small f. It will produce a scalar. And in case of curl, del is operated as cross product of a vector field, and the cross product of two vector field will result another vector field. So suppose this is f dash, this is also a vector. So here I can say that in this question, this is asking for curl of grad of f, gradient of f. So as this is curl operation, final curl operation, so this will result in vector. So option D is correct answer. And why this is zero magnitude? Because grad f or gradient of a scalar is always an irrotational vector. As this is irrotational, curl of any irrotational vector will be always equal to zero. So this is equal to zero, and this is zero vector or null vector. So another method to know this, when we form gradient of a scalar field and want to again multiply it or cross product it with the differential operator, then if we consider it as single planar vectors, then the angle between both will be zero. And hence the cross product is magnitude multiplied by sine angle between them. So here angle is zero. So this will result zero magnitude. So next question. Question number 2. The directional derivative of f of xy is equal to x square plus 3y square plus z square at point P 213 is the direction of vector A is equal to I cap minus 2 k cap. So how we can represent a directional derivative? So here I am going to explain how we can explain directional derivative. Directional derivative is represented by gradient of the scalar, because here this is given one scalar, not vector. F is a scalar here, so gradient of a scalar at point P, and then it is multiplied by the direction or the unit vector along the direction given. So here this direction is given, A is equal to something. Here is the direction, and the point is also given, P is equal to something. So we can calculate this as I cap gradient, I am getting the gradient del by del x plus j cap. I am writing this as cap, as I have a habit from the 12th class. This is cap. I am habituated with this one, so I am writing it as cap. You can write arrow mark or as vector symbol upon that, k, j, I, etc. So 3y square plus z square, this is the this is at P point, and this will be multiplied by I cap minus 2k cap, given magnitude is minus 2 whole square root over. So here it is coming 4x I cap plus 6y j cap plus 2z k cap at P, multiplied by I cap minus 2 k cap by root over 1 plus 4. And this is coming to be, if we put P is equal to 1, the value given is 2, 1, 3, then this is x value, y value and z value. So if we put x value here, y value here, z value here, this will be 4 into 2, that is 8 I cap plus 6 into 1, 6 j cap plus 2 into 3, that is 6 k cap into this one is 1 by root 5 I cap minus 2 by root 5 k cap. So dot product here will be, here is dot product here will be, this will be multiplied with this one, and as there is no j value in the second one, there it will be 0 and k value will be multiplied with this one. So here it will be 8 by root 5 minus 12 by root 5, which is coming to be 4 by root 5. So here we, if we consider the options, then minus 4 by root 5. Next question, Stokes theorem connects a linear and a surface integral, option A is given as a linear integral and a surface integral, option B is surface integral and volume integral, option C is a linear integral and a volume integral, and option D is gradient of a function and its surface integral. So here is the Stokes theorem. If S is a surface bounded by a simple closed curve C and A is a differentiable vector function, then closed integral of A is equal to surface integral of curl of A. And here n vector is perpendicular to the surface. This is the Stokes theorem, and this is connecting a linear integral to surface integral. So here a line integral and a surface integral, option A. Next question, question number 4, the vector field F is equal to x I cap minus y j cap, where I and j are unit vectors, is divergence free but not irrotational. We have to find out what is the terms irrotational and divergence free are used for. So when the divergence of a vector field is equal to 0, that is divergence free. And when curl of a vector field is equal to 0 vector, then this is called irrotational. Irrotational. Divergence free is also called solenoidal or incompressible. So here we have to check both divergence and curl of that vector. So first we have to check divergence. Del dot f is equal to del operation of del by del x I cap plus del by del y j cap plus del y del z k cap, dot product, then x I cap minus y j cap, given vector is x I cap minus y j cap here. So here it will be, when we take the derivative, this term is not present, so this term will be 0, and this will be multiplied or operate with the I term, and this will be operate with, sorry, there is J term, no K term, so K term will be 0, so this will be operated with this one. So if we operate x with del by del x, so it will be 1 minus 1, which is equal to 0. So it is divergence free. And next, if we operate call del cross f is equal to, this is calculated as a matrix I cap, J cap, K cap, del by del x, del by del y, del by del z, and here x minus y 0 as given. So this also will be equal to I cap 0 minus 0 here, and plus J cap 0 minus 0 plus K cap 0 minus 0, which is coming to be a 0 vector. So this is also irrotational. So if we consider the options, option C is the correct answer, divergence free and irrotational. Next question, question number 5, for the function phi is equal to ax square y minus y cube, to represent the velocity potential of an ideal fluid, del square f should be equal to 0. In that case, the value of a. So forget all these things and only consider del square phi is equal to 0 and what will the value of a. This is the question. And what is del square? Del square is called Laplacian operator. Laplacian of phi. And if we talk about the Laplacian, this is double derivative and this is a scalar operator. How? This is del square by del x square plus del square by del y square plus del square by del z square. This is del square, that is Laplacian operator, and this can operate both scalar and vector. How? If del square operate a scalar, then this will be del dot gradient of phi. Phi is a scalar, and this is the actual formula. And this will result also a scalar because this is a dot product. And how it operates a vector? When del square of a vector then it will be del of, that is gradient of del dot f, this is a scalar and this is the gradient, the whole term will be a vector, and minus del cross f, this is a vector and the whole term will be a vector, and the result will be also a vector form. So we can conclude that when Laplacian operator operates a scalar, it will result a scalar, and if it operates with a vector, it will result another vector. So here it is asking for a scalar, and here given that del square phi is equal to 0, that means it is obeying the Laplacian equation, and in case of that, if an equation or function obeys the Laplacian equation, we can say that is steady, incompressible, irrotational flow in case of fluid dynamics. and we can write it as 2ay, because if we operate this one, 2 time derivative of this one with respect to x, that is partial derivative 2ay, because x will be wiped out, and minus 6y, first derivative will be 3y, next derivative will be 3 into 2 into y, here will be 3y square, and second derivative will be 3 into 2 into y, that is 6y. So this will be 0, and if we calculate a will be 6y by 2y, which is equal to 3. So answer here is 3. So next question number 6, del cross p, where p is a vector, is equal to. So I have already written here in the last question that here if we clean this one, I have written here that del square f, that is a vector, is del of del dot f minus del cross f, I have written here. And if we found this one, then what will be the answer? Del, that is gradient of divergence of f, minus del square, that is Laplacian of f, this will be del cross f. So in this question, this is asking for the same. So this will be, answer is option number D, that is gradient of divergence of p minus del square of p. P is a vector given here. So next question number 7, del of a cross b, and a and b both are vector quantities. So this is the scalar triple product formula we can apply, and this will be equal to b dot del cross a minus, this is a formula, b dot del cross a minus a dot del cross b. So option b is the correct answer. This is one of the formula, we have to remember this one. Next question number 8, if del cross f vector is equal to null vector or zero vector, then f vector is said to be, this is irrotational, or this can be called as conservative. We have to remember those terms, because these are generally acquainted with mechanical engineering terms. So we have to remember this one, what is irrotational, what is sinusoidal, and what are conservative, these terms. Next questions, the divergence of the vector field, given field is here, is dash, and how divergence is calculated, this is the dot product of vector field. So this is del by del x I cap plus del by del y j cap plus del by del z k cap of the whole f. I am not writing here, and this will be, if we operate first one dot product, so this will be operate with this one, this will be operate with this one, and the last one will operate with this one. So it will be first derivative of x minus y with respect to x, this will be 1 and y will be 0. So 1 plus next this will be also 1 and plus this will be also 1. So answer is 3. So option D is correct answer. Next question, question number 10. Which of the following statement is wrong about an irrotational vector f? This is option number B is the correct answer, that is because this is asking for wrong. Which is wrong? Because for irrotational I have already explained del cross f is equal to 0 vector. This is true. And if we consider option number C, line integral of f depends upon the end point. Also this is true. Also depends upon end point. And line integral of f along simple closed path is 0. This is also true. And option number D is the wrong answer, because this is given line integral of f along a simple closed path is non-zero. Actually this is 0 as option D. So option B is the correct answer, which is given wrong statement. Question number 11. Closed surface integral is equal to volume integral of divergence of that vector. Which theorem is it? And this is Gauss divergence theorem. And this is Gauss divergence theorem. That is, the closed surface integral is equal to volume integral of divergence of that vector. This is Gauss divergence theorem. Question number 12. If R is the position vector of any point on a closed surface what encloses the volume V, then double integral over S of S dot ds is equal to. This is, we can here apply, I have not explained in the last question because here is the application of that Gauss divergence theorem. And here R is given position vector, and we know that position vector is always expressed as I x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. Because position vector in 3D field, position vector, suppose this is x, y, z, and in terms of vector this will be represented as this one. This is the position vector from origin to that point in that direction. This is the position vector of a point. So if R is this one, so what will be the integral equal to? So according to Gauss divergence theorem, this will be equal to the formula volume, as here I have volume integral of the divergence of that vector. So this will be volume integral of divergence, that is dot product divergence of that vector. So what is the divergence? If we take divergence, that is del y del x I cap plus del y del y j cap plus del y del z k cap. If we dot product with x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap, so what will be? It will be operate with this one, it will be operate with this one, and last one will operate with the last one. So this will be 1 plus 1 plus 1, so this will be 3. So here this will be triple integral over V 3 dv. So this will be 3V, 3 into volume. So option D is the correct answer here. This is very easy question. Next question, consider the point P and Q in xy plane with P is equal to 1, 0 and Q is equal to 0, 1. Then line integral 2 into integral from p to q x dy plus y dx along the semicircle with the line segment pq as its diameter is. Here we need not physically draw or anything, we have to only apply Green theorem here. Another theorem is Green theorem. So what will be it? Green theorem describes as closed integral over C m dx plus n dy is equal to the double integral of dn by dx plus, sorry, this is minus dm by dy dx dy. So here the question given is 2 into pq x dy plus y dx. So here m is x, n is y. So if we put in the formula del of del n by del x, what will be it? Del n by del x, this will be 0, minus del m by del y, del m by del y, this will be also be 0, 0 minus 0 dx dy double integral, and this will be 0. So answer will be 0. So answer will be is 0. So next question, question number 14. A cross B cross C plus B cross C cross A plus C cross A cross B is equal to 0 vector is dash. Which identity? This is Jacobi identity. This is Jacobi identity. Next question, if scalar triple product is 0, then three vectors are perpendicular to each other, option B coplanar, option C parallel in different planes, option D none of the above. So this is coplanar, because scalar triple product, if we define the scalar triple product is generally given as, suppose A vector dot B cross C, this is the scalar triple product. Scalar triple product, because B cross C is a vector and vector dot product of vector another, this will be a scalar. So this is a scalar triple product. And how this is a coplanar? If scalar triple product is 0, suppose this is equal to 0, and how this is coplanar? Because this is a vector, suppose D vector, A dot A vector dot D vector is equal to 0. That means A magnitude dot B magnitude multiplied D magnitude into cos something, suppose X is equal to 0. When it will be 0? When x is equal to 90 degree. That means cos 90 degree is equal to 0 and the whole value will be 0. So when it will be 90 degree, D and A have the mutual angle is 90 degree. How this is possible? Because the B cross C has the result which is perpendicular to both. Because in case of dot product or cos, in case of cross product, the result is perpendicular to both the vectors. So the vector D will be perpendicular to both B and C. It will be inward to the surface or outward from the surface. So when these two are in the same plane and A is also in the same plane, then it is possible that the whole scalar triple product will be 0. So this is coplanar. Option C is another confusing. Parallel in different planes. If both are parallel or all are parallel in different planes, suppose here all are parallel in single plane. If two are parallel, then it's the cross product. Suppose this is B, this is C, and this is A. Cross product of B cross C will be zero vector, and A cross A dot zero will also be equal to zero. But in here it is given that parallel in different planes. When B is one plane and C is another plane, in another plane, then the cross product is impossible, and this is not defined because they are not crossing each other or not in the same plane. So option C is not a correct answer. Option B, that is coplanar, is the correct answer. Question number 16. If phi is equal to 2x cube y square z 4, then Laplacian of phi is dash. So we have to calculate this one. Laplacian, that means double derivative. Del square x square, del square by del x square plus del square by del y square plus del square by del z square of the same vector. So if we consider first one, the first derivative will be 2 y square z 4 into 3 x square. So next derivative will be 6 y square z 4 into 2 x. So this will be 12 x y square z 4. First term. What will be the next term? Next term will be its first derivative with respect to y will be 2x cube z 4 2 y, and next time it will be 4 x cube z to the power 4. So this will be the next derivative. And if we consider the z term with respect to z, then this will be 2 x cube y square 4 into z 3, first derivative. And next derivative will be 8 into x cube y square 3 z square. This will be 24 x cube y square z square. So where it is this? In option C, this is all the terms are matching. 12 x y square z 4 plus 4 x cube z 4 plus 24 x cube y square z square. So next question. For the three vectors, which of the following is not correct? Which of the following is not correct? So here A dot B cross C is B dot C cross A. This is correct. A dot B cross C is equal to A cross B dot C. This is also correct. A dot B cross C is equal to A dot C cross B. This is not correct. This will be negative of A dot C cross B. And here A dot A cross B is equal to 0. This is also correct. Because in this term, this will be perpendicular to A. The whole term will be perpendicular to A, and here A and perpendicular to A, that means cos 90. Cos 90 means 0. So next question, question number 18. Which differential operator in vector calculus measures the scalar of A source or sink at a given point in a given vector field. This is nothing but the divergence. This is the actual definition of divergence. If we found anywhere, this is the definition of divergence. So next question, the line integral of the gradient of a scalar field over a curve is equal to the change in the scalar field between the endpoints. Which theorem is it? This is the gradient theorem. I am making these questions because I want to make you know the definitions of gradient theorem, divergence theorem, and all these things. So this is the last question, and in the next slide I am going to explain what are the important topics from the vector calculus. So what are the main topics? One is vector and scalar triple product. This is not vector calculus, but this is the base to the vector calculus, so this should be known to us. Second one is gradient, divergence, and curl. Vector calculus starts from here, and these are operated with the del operator or nabla operator, and this is called the differential operator in vector calculus, and their properties and their identities, gradient, divergence, and curl, their properties. Next is, third part is the theorems. What are Stokes theorem, Green theorem, and Gauss divergence theorem, and their transformations from what to what? From Stokes theorem, from linear integral to surface integral, and Gauss divergence theorem is from surface integral to volume integral. So this we have to remember, and this is the main part of the vector calculus, and this is very small chapter in mathematics, engineering mathematics. So this may be very easy. So thank you for watching up to here.